Call of Duty 4, veteran difficulty guide. This is Rebel Link, and this is One Shot, One Kill. Okay, so now we're back to some good old strategery. This opening part, when I first played it, I wanted more of this, you know? I like how they encompass all those things they just talked about right there. The wind, distance, Coriolis effect, all that good business. Telling you, if Call of Duty made them just a sniping game, it'd be phenomenal. It'd be tons of fun. Tons of fun. We could play Tom Berenger. If y'all don't know, there's a series of movies called Sniper, and Tom Berenger is the lead role. Anyways, so on veteran difficulty, one of the things you'll notice if you're playing it for the first time is this part here, the wind acts up a lot more, or the variables act up a lot more, so you gotta be very careful. And usually around that same time where I just shot, aim a little outside of his shoulder when he's in that certain animation where he's throwing his arms down, and usually it'll curve just enough to the right to where you'll get that shot every time. So now comes the fun part, or at least this video we're going to cover up all the way up to the Ferris wheel, or video game hell, as some of my friends call it. Then the second video, we're obviously going to go into the hardest part. At least, well, some of my friends say, arguably the hardest part of the game. First time I played through it, I'll be honest, that's when I got up to there and I was like, fuck this game. But, yeah. So anyways, what you're going to want to do here is wait for everybody to get settled, all those enemies to get in position. Toss a flashbang there. Probably a good idea to throw one right where I was just looking, because these guys end up shooting me a little bit. And then just make a break for it. They won't chase you. Just sprint for it. Don't worry about McTavish or McMillan, whatever the hell our partner's name is. He'll make it to you. That may take a few times. I think it took me about 3 times. I had to edit out a death there, but it took me only about 3 times to get part. Past that part, just using that strategy. Again, just wait everybody to set up. Throw some flashbangs and sprint. Probably a good idea to kill that dog, because if you don't, he's going to chase you in the building. So make sure and take him out. It's interesting how this gun, the G3, in the game, you're able to use it as a fully automatic, but you're not able to use it as a fully automatic in multiplayer. So, interesting. So this part's not too hard. I play roulette with it here in a second. Dance in front of it. What's funny is I had to edit out a stupid death here, because as it was landing, I tried to knife it in the midair. yeah, I died. apparently, if you touch that helicopter while it's in its crashing animation, you die, because all I did was just barely touch it and I died. So, whatever, right? So, here I didn't take McMillan far enough, so I'm like wondering where those guys are at, and I realize that I didn't take them far enough. So, probably a little past that pole right there. There you go. You see enemy already coming right there, but that's a good spot to leave them. Throw a grenade. You're gonna get three guys from this side, and these guys around the corners are crack shots. So let McMillan take them out, and I don't have to worry about it. But now this next section is kind of weird because I've had more than, I think, four or five enemies show up, and then that's it. He said, this place is clear, let's move on. But I've had like 10 enemies show up, including, you know, the people in the helicopter, so. It is funny, these guys get pwned so hard. It's called the business right there. So he said, this area is clear, but usually that's a good spot to leave them to. And he usually takes out guys that will come out from the left there. Alright, so the helicopter's coming to drop off more dudes. Ignore it completely and just keep walking. You just got a checkpoint. So, might as well just try this on your first time. See if you get it. And just make your way all the way over here, because they will not chase you into this building. If you don't, then set down McMillan again, and you know, take out the people that they drop off in the helicopter. Not too hard though. So this part, there are three dogs. There's a guy in that room. A guy in the hallway, and usually a guy out of to your left. So. There's the second dog, or the first dog. Maybe just two dogs, I can't remember. Usually a guy right there where I just looked, but he wasn't there. So there's only that guy, but, and there's dog number two. Okay, just two dogs. But, don't take that part for granted, because I've definitely remember playing through this part before and more people in this area. So the hard part is done, at least for this half of the game. Hope that strategy worked for you guys. There's two more scouting people left coming up here in a second. And then take them out. Make sure you're fully stocked up on your ammo. Preferably have your AK-47 out. Or hopefully you picked one up earlier. Because that is one of the more powerful guns in this game. And we're going to need it to be taking out some guys here. So feel free to pick up that Dragunov if you want it. I really don't use a sniper rifle a lot, so I didn't pick it up, but alright, so as I ended this video, we'll see you guys in hell next.